family loves a thing to work at. Gotta work, work, work to keep that thing alive. I hear what you're selling, I don't buy that.
Kevin and Michael Bacon, the Bacon Brothers, have been impressing audiences for decades. Their music's a blend of folk, rock, soul, and country. They have performed everywhere from Carnegie Hall to the Grand Ole Opry, and they are in town for some shows tonight and tomorrow at the Metropolis Performing Arts Center in Arlington Heights. And guys, it's great to have you back with us. Thanks for coming
nice
in.
Thanks for having us.
How much fun is it for you guys? Is it just like a break in your day job for you guys to get together? And
well, playing is always fun. You know, that's always the good part. Get in front of people, sharing songs that you've written. A lot of people think that I need a break from my day job, but I really don't. I really like my day job. You know, I've been doing it for a long time, but it's not like I look at the music and go, oh, thank God I don't have to act. You know.
You know? I keep thinking, Michael, that both of you guys, it's like I have two sisters, and I mean, I see them pretty regularly, but if I had to be on the road with my sisters,
no, it's awful. Just
fun. It's not a problem here, and it all works out?
It really does. I think that people have an image of brother bands as being kind of negative, Everly Brothers, Oasis, Beach Boys fighting, but I'm 9 years older, so I don't think we ever had that kind of battling brother syndrome that would carry over into our adult life. So, no, we don't really fight.
And it's like 100, you've done like 130 shows over 3 years. It's not like this is just a once in a while thing. You guys are always touring together.
We play, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. You know, it's really about the songwriting, I think, because we're really a songwriting band. You know, after we did our first show, I think if we hadn't written a bunch of songs through the years and wanted to share them, I don't know if we would still be doing it. Mm-hmm. But we keep writing songs, and we keep wanting to play them and get in the studio. And
were you guys musical kids growing up in Philadelphia, musical house?
Yeah, our parents, it was really a creative house. We have four sisters, so six of us in this little skinny house in the middle of Philadelphia. And they valued creativity above everything else. So if you wanted to act, you wanted to take art classes, dance, music, all those things. It was a little kind of Athenian society.
Yeah, that's opposite of what most parents are like, isn't it?
Yeah, yeah. They didn't care about grades. No sports.
Yeah, it's awesome.
The most awesome parents in the world.
Well, you know, now,
when I look back at my record collection from 35 years ago, every once in a while I'll pull one out and say, oh my God, I can't believe I bought that. Do you have one? Do you have an Ace of Base or something in your collection?
Yeah, I would say probably. Well, my actual record collection, the vinyl, has gotten a little bit mixed up between me and my wife. So there's some things in there that I don't think I got them. I mean, you know, stuff like, listen, no offense, but she's a really giant Barry Manilow fan.
No, I love it.
Yeah, yeah. Speaking of which, not speaking of Barry, but I've noticed you gave a shout out to John Stamos on his birthday. Very nice. But you know, it's Kira Sedgwick's birthday as well.
Wow.
Do you have fun facts about her?
You kind of dropped the ball on that one. Yeah.
Well, if a ball's to be dropped, it's going to happen on this show. So. God, you guys have been married how long now?
30 years.
Wow.
And what are your plans for her birthday? Apparently nothing since you're here.
Here we are.
Unless she's going to be darling tonight.
I'm going to be on this television show.
God.
And she will never see it. So happy birthday, honey. I love you. All the way to New York.
Talk to me about City on a Hill, your Showtime series. I know that they just announced there's going to be a season two, which is great. You play such a dark, disturbing character.
Yeah, it's awful guy.
On the show.
Terrible.
Are these like really fun characters to play?
You know, I think characters that are fun are characters that are complex and well written. And it's not so much about whether or not it's more fun to be a good guy or a bad guy. A lot of people have that idea that, oh, bad guys are all fun. You know, but listen, I mean, you could be a hero as long as he's got, you know, good stuff to play. I'm going to enjoy it. Hmm.
And this is a Boston accent kind of thing, and Larry's from Boston.
Right.
That's what he said.
I heard that you've been working to try to get rid of your Boston accent.
Oh, it's been a long thing. We have a couple of beers, and then we go into the garage, and then my brother's in there. I can't control it.
That's awesome. Yeah. That's awesome.
What do you consider to be your most iconic roles, Kevin? You certainly have had some amazing movies in your career.
I don't know. You know, I mean, I think that there were certain things that kind of turned, you know, they become kind of like benchmark type moments, like from a career standpoint, and then you sort of roll along for a while and then something positive happens, you know. I mean, you know, Footloose was a giant thing. JFK was really, really helpful because JFK to me was a moment where I realized, and I think, you know, other people realized that I'm really more of a character actor than a leading man, and so that was important. Hmm.
Michael, when you two are making music and a disagreement emerges over the nature of the music, how is that resolved?
I don't think we disagree too much. We have such a commonality of our aesthetic. I guess it's been in our, you know, our souls since we were little kids.
That's his way of saying he wins.
I'd like to think it was resolved like with my brother. Somebody winds up in a headlock.
I could try that. Yeah. I could try that. Yeah. We did have an arm wrestling contest on national television once, and I won that. So maybe that's so intimidating that he just lets me win.
Yeah. And Michael, your day job, you are a composer. I mean, you are in music all the time, right?
Yeah. I write music for films and television shows, and I'm an associate professor of music in the CUNY system in New York City.
Oh, wow.
I'm trying to get my cello concerto launched, so I'm pretty much a music man. It's the only thing I know how to do. Yeah. So luckily I've been able to make a living at it all these years.
So well, it's so great to see you guys again. Yeah.
Thanks for having us.
Thanks for coming in. You can check out the Bacon Brothers tonight and tomorrow at the Metropolis Performing Arts Center in Arlington Heights. For more info, go to baconbros.com. And they're going to be performing later in the show. Happy birthday to Kira Sedgwick.